The evening of August 13, 2018 was a dark one in Arua, one this country hadn't seen in a long time. As supporters of one of the contenders for the Arua municipality seat, Kassiano Wadri, converged on the town to consolidate their last strategies, chaos broke out. Security agencies say opposition supporters stormed the presidential motorcade. In the violent aftermath, many people were injured, some sporting gunshot wounds. About 100 people were arrested, and 33 of these were whisked off to Gulu, which is a four-hour drive from Arua, and charged with treason. Knight Asara, a councillor for Arua Hill Division, was one of these people.
There were many acts and sideshows in the Arua fracas last year. While some attained glory and fame, others are still nursing wounds. Arua turned Knight Asara into a cripple. In just one night, she came from a financially independent woman to a beggar, a defiant beggar.
Mungu minizia maniri si. Anira, Mungu Uganda's minizia maniri ni amazakoni.
The former teacher's souvenir from that night is a crutch. She says she was severely assaulted by a security officer.
My left leg on left hand side is not proper. That was the most part which was damaged. And as I'm talking now, I still have difficulties. Sometimes eating too much becomes a problem. And when I'm hungry, it also becomes a problem. Eventually, even newly, I've developed high blood pressure.
Asara says the injuries ended any sexual relations she had with her partner, who eventually walked out of the relationship. She never received specialized care, though.
The pain I go through at night, it is very difficult. And I'm also feeling like suing the government, because by torturing me, by beating me, government has denied my sexual rights, and that is the right of a human being.
Consequently, her family life has changed tremendously, though she continues to struggle to fend for her children.
When I'm defeated and I'm stuck somewhere, if I cannot get from friends, I sell anything in the house to see my children go to school. When I get my schoolmates, when I get my workmates, when I get my friends, they give me money 5,000, they give me 10,000, they give me 20,000. Most what part is that the bankers, the microfinance have stopped giving me loan. Why? It's because they are fearing the charge. They say that something to do with the government and I'm a suspect. The charge is treason.
Last year, Asara filed a civil suit against a security officer. She claims that since that time, there have been 5 attempts on her life and that her children, the youngest of whom is 3 years old, live in fear. But in retrospect, she says she does not regret what she went through.
We need the people of this country to understand exactly where this country is heading.
The Arua fracas seems to have emboldened Asara and to some extent given her political mileage. The 40-year-old, whose first husband was killed by the Lord's Resistance Army, intends to stand either as a mayoral aspirant or woman member of parliament in 2021. Gillian Nantume, NTV.